What's going on, guys? It's LadyB, and I am back with some more strategy guides, but we're talking about key components of strategy guides. So today we're going to talk about one of the more common funneling strategies that we see right now called the Suey Blimp, and it involves utilizing Yetis to help your funnels. And we're seeing this in Town Hall 12 and Town Hall 13, so stay tuned as we break it down. So the use of the Suey Blimp is becoming more increasingly common in Town Hall 13, and we're also seeing it in Town Hall 12. And basically what you're doing is you're utilizing a blimp with some Yetis in it. The typical breakdown for Town Hall 13 is about two Yetis, one Barb and a Valk. And then you're utilizing a Rage, and then possibly, depending on what's around, a Freeze and a Poison and sometimes Loon for the proper funneling to allow the blimp into where you want to get. So with this, you are looking to take down either the town hall when we see these outside town halls, or sometimes some second layer defenses. And really, this is enabling you to do some queen walks or queen charges that you might not necessarily be able to do. And also it creates better pathing for hits that might not necessarily have been allowed previously. You're also eliminating, when you do eliminate the town hall, the Giga Bomb. You're eliminating, particularly for Yeti Smashes, the need for your troops to have to actually cut through going straight to the town hall, which most Yeti Smashes in the traditional sense have to gravitate towards. And it gives you just a little bit more value with your Grand Warden because you can utilize it differently. You're not worrying about when you need to pop that tome ability. You can extend it a little bit further into the base, particularly for those scatter shots. So let's take a look and then start breaking down. I have two examples for you in Town Hall 13 and two examples in Town Hall 12, all in varying types of attacks. The first and probably most common one that we see it with is the hybrid, though we're starting to see it more and more with Yeti Smash. So let's take a look here as Lex, who is one of the first people to actually come up with this. He was definitely the first person that I saw doing it and putting out a video on it. So make sure to check out his channel as well, as I'm sure he has great advice with this particular strategy. So he starts off the attack here. You can see the town hall's kind of on the outskirts. He's looking to go in with the hybrid, the Hogs and the Miners, and he essentially wants to allow for some better pathing. He wants to narrow out the pathing here and give his queen good direction and allow the king to do some work on the outside as well. So sending this in straight to the town hall, you can see those Yetis get right in there and they're taking on a lot of heat. I will say, normally you should be pretty cautious of scatter shots because they can actually damage the Yetimite. So it really depends on the position of where the scatter shots hit and what they're targeting, and those skellies, those can be they can be a bit problematic. It's just the conjunction of that with he's taken on the heat from two ground expos, an AT and a scatter shot, plus he's got those skellies right on top. But fortunately for him, the Yetimites actually did some quick and nasty work on that town hall, taking it down. You can see everything under that rage. Yetimites just splitting up, but dying out here at the tail end. You do have to be mindful that if you're coming up on a CC, you're going to have to pull it to the side and take it out either with your queen or with the baby dragon. Just have some sort of plan in order to take out the CC. But as you can see, he's created such great pathing. The queen's working up on the 3 o'clock side. He took out the entire 7:30 side chamber there, allowing the king to work on the outside of the base, taking care of that side of the funneling here. And the pathing is super narrow now for his hybrid. And if he had not taken down the town hall that way, if he had gone more of a traditional way, allowing the queen to work in, it really would have shaped this very differently. King would have had to have worked on the opposite side, and he would have been worrying about the damage that the queen was going to take on from that scatter shot. So you're really investing quite little on your troop space, on your housing space, because essentially all you're doing is bringing in a blimp and then maybe some loons that you're bringing on your own. So it's your siege machine along with maybe a couple of spells, your rage, and then if you need a freeze, and a poison. So keep that in mind, that this really works out nicely and again creates some great value here. You can see that king working along that entire side, going up towards the 9 o'clock side, queen wrapping from the opposite end here, and that initial pathing, the initial entry point for the hybrid, was narrowed out considerably. So Lex does pick up the triple with this one, makes it look super easy, but it really does give you that sense of how you can change the shaping of your entry points. Now this is something that, like I said, if you're doing something like a Yeti Smash, where you have to head towards a town hall, and we're gonna take a look at this one coming up. So if you're taking a look at something like a Yeti Smash, where you have to typically worry about your Yetis coming through, having to work into the town hall and just pathing a particular way, this is such a game changer. So as you can see here, Loop from my Aunt Teezy goes in with the Sui blimp. And again, targeting that town hall, probably one of the more common approaches that we see, is to go for that town hall, gets it right in there and opens up that pathing. Now this is now narrowed out on one portion of the base, eliminating that town hall for the Yetis. And that's the other key thing, is that this is essentially lightening up the load for Yeti Smashes and the Queen or Grand Warden walks going in. So he eliminates that entire chamber over on the 8 o'clock side, allows his queen to start pathing, working through, and then we're gonna see him drop that jump. My mic's covering it here, but you can see the four quakes here to open up the center of the base. So the king's able to work through the outskirts, queen working her way in, and it's that initial setup point here now for his Yeti Smash working its way in that is super narrow. It keeps everything working together nicely. They're not getting hung up on the freeze, so he doesn't have to worry with the Giga Bomb having to force that ability here. He does use it early on because of the Eagle, but the fact that those two units are spread out makes such a huge impact that he already eliminated it with just the blimp, the CC troops that were inside, and a rage and a couple of loons. So really big impact on that one. And again, freezes you can use for those scatter shots when you're worried about it. It's always a good shout to just plan for the worst, because you don't necessarily, you don't want to lose the value. That's the most important thing, is getting that value initially with very little expended. But for what you're using, you want to make sure you get it done. And again, that narrow pathing really kept everything going strong throughout the base. The early Grand Warden Tome was able to be utilized to take out the Eagle, keep everything safe going through that, and that's going to be one of the bigger contenders here. But again, picking up the triple here and just re-navigating how we think about these types of attacks and our queen walks and pathing and approach. And you can honestly wind up allowing yourself an entry on a less heavy DPS portion of the base. Now here we get to see it in use with Town Hall 12, because you do have a Giga Bomb to worry about with Town Hall 12 in the Town Hall itself. It's nice to be able to eliminate that as well. So naturally, this is something that you might want to gravitate towards if you're using Hogs Hybrid. I don't know that we're seeing it necessarily with Yeti Smashes at this point within Town Hall 12, but interesting. And we'll take a look, because we've got this Hog attack and we also have one with a minor attack. So those ground troops, this works perfectly with. So in this war, this was a GML, the German Midweek League Finals. 11 original went up against Void. Kala picked this up, going in and eliminating, again, the Town Hall. Probably one of the more common things. The next one I'm going to show you shows the second layer defense and how that works. So he comes in here, sends it right into the Town Hall. Now, the purpose isn't to take out all of the structures around it. You just want to get some impact. You want to get some key components here. And he goes for the Town Hall, knocks that down on that quadrant here, and then you're gonna see exactly how it shapes up. He is enabled to send in a slew of mass hogs. He starts his queen first over here on about the 830 side of the base, And the way he sends in his queen, it's pretty impressive. Or the way he sends in his hogs, it's pretty impressive because he gives his queen so much value to the tail end. So as you can see, again, something that I mentioned about being mindful of the CC is that you know how you're going to take it out, obviously, either with your queen charge portion or as he does here with the baby dragon in the corner, so he's able to eliminate it. Don't want to fast forward this too quickly. We'll get into the nitty gritty in just a second here. But the ice golem here to start off the tanking for the queen initially, to give her a little bit of room to breathe on those defenses, and then he sends in the hogs. And again, as you can see here, he's able to just divide up the pathing to allow the hogs to naturally gravitate back into the center of the base, not worrying too much about the defenses on the outskirts there. And this enables his queen to actually work her way through all the way to the end. And there's a back end Tesla farm here that the queen is able to power through, and we even see a swag ability. So the hogs coming through, knowing that he has nothing to take out the queen here in the center of the base, he opts for the AQ Skelly kill and makes easy work of it coming through here. And this queen, as you can see, is going super strong, still has her ability coming up on this 12 o'clock side back end Tesla farm here. And with the hogs meeting up with her, they're able to take it out collectively together and spare the queen's ability here. You can see he's got a loon coming in for the support on that cannon on the outskirts. He does get a nice split with a couple of the hogs working through the outside of the base there. And King working his way on the outskirts as well. And King taking on the attention of that hound. The baby dragon was obviously taken out, and the hound able to leave everything else alone. Skelly's still going strong, taking on the structures inside the base as everything wraps around for the cleanup here. And again, a beautiful example of how you can utilize this to rethink your entry points and how you can shape up a base for sending in various strategies. One last example of this particular strategy for funneling is with the miners, and this is actually taking on a second layer defense. So we're not seeing the blimp coming in to take down the town hall. Instead, we're seeing it come in to take down that multi-targeting inferno that's just past the defenses here. And it opens up a different approach into how he would actually path this base. So sections that off, the Yeti mites come in and take out that portion of the base here. He's able to then utilize his queen, wall breaker in, take on the town hall. And what you're gonna notice is where this queen comes in, he's already sectioned off a portion of this base here, right on the inside where his king can't necessarily reach. His queen would have to have charged in there, but he's now allowed his king some great funneling opportunity. Queen comes in, funnels the opposite side of the base, which narrows out the entire entry point for the miners coming through. And really that's what it comes down to. Whatever lead you can give your troops, I always talk about this on stream, narrowing out the pathing initially, allowing your troops some time to work together, not to spread apart, is such huge value. And that is exactly what this Sui blimp is allowing players to do now. So Queen works her way through after taking on the town hall. And because she eliminates that, again, it's another way that you're giving a little more room to breathe for your miners, and when you can actually use the Grand Warden ability, because you want to worry not about the Town Hall, not about the Gigabomb, but you want to worry about that Eagle. So gets a Grand Warden in with the miners. Everything paths through. Queen is able to continue on her way, pathing down. King was a beast here, going almost down that entire section of the base. So Grand Warden Tome keeping those miners safe through before they get to the Eagle. He's able to delay that a little bit because he didn't have to use it for the Town Hall, and able to just really power through this one as well. As you can see, those miners, they do have to backtrack a little bit But ultimately, he got exactly the funnel and the pathing that he wanted, and eliminating that eagle pretty early on there. Back end Tesla farm again on this one, and the queen just powers through, helps out, and the miners are able to do the job of picking up the triple. Again, just to recap here, for the Sui blimp, you're going to utilize in Town Hall 13, two Yetis, a Valk, and a Barbarian, along with a Rage, and then optional loons, depending on the pathing you need to create. Obviously, you want to make sure you pick up any air traps along the way, and take out some of the defenses that might be in front of it to allow it the time it needs to get to whatever key structures you're going for. So very little value needed on that. And then obviously a freeze if you're worried about certain placements, particularly scatter shots, and potentially a poison if needed, but actually that can be held till later on when you're looking to take out the CC troops. And then for Town Hall 12, you're gonna use two Yetis, four barbs, and then again, you'll need the Rage, and then potentially if you need some loons for the pathing and a freeze along the way. So very limited troop space needed in order to get this done, but you can pick up so much value. Let me know your thoughts below in the comments, what you think about this particular way of funneling. Is it something that you've tried yet? Will you try it? If you've tried it, let me know. I've got my social media in the chat below. You can post any of your screenshots or video replays to me on Twitter, or you can join my Discord server and post it there. If you enjoyed the video, please make sure that you hit the thumbs up. And if you're not subscribed, it costs you nothing to subscribe to the channel, so very much appreciated. But don't forget to turn your notifications on so you know when my videos drop. Until next time, this is LadyB. I'll catch you guys later.